From software to hardware, today I'm going to share with you the 12 tools that I use almost every day to protect my data, my personal information, and my overall privacy. If you're looking to make an upgrade to your own privacy online, I think that you'll find this list to be particularly useful. A quick note before we begin. None of the companies or products paid to be on this list or sponsored this in any way. These are legitimately the tools that I use on a daily basis. My goal with All Things Secured is to provide you with the tips and the tools that you need to secure your accounts and your personal data. So if that's something you're interested in, be sure to subscribe to this channel. All right, let's begin. By far the most utilized tool on this list is my password manager. I use it every single day. Now, there may come a time when passwords are no longer part of the login process, but until that day comes, and I really think that's a few years down the road, a password manager is a must-have tool for anybody who uses the internet. The primary purpose of using a password manager is twofold. First, it helps you create unique and secure passwords, which is something that most of us are really bad at doing. Second, it removes that friction of online logins by auto-filling those strong passwords across all of your devices. Now, I personally use 1Password, but I also really love ProtonPass and Bitwarden as alternative options if you're looking for that. If you've watched any of my videos before, you already know how I feel about two-factor authentication. In fact, in the video where I described my online security strategy, I shared this rule that I have. If an account allows for a physical security key, I use it. This 2FA key from YubiKey goes everywhere I go, and I have a backup that I keep elsewhere in case something were to happen to this. There is usually some point throughout my day where I have to plug this key into my computer or tap it on the back of my phone in order to authenticate my login. For my daily internet usage, I've moved away from the popular Chrome browser simply because of how Google uses it to collect vast amounts of data and connect it to our personal profiles. Even when you're using incognito mode, tracking still persists. Now, there are a lot of great options available like Firefox, DuckDuckGo, Molvad browser, and others. I've landed on Brave. It's the one I like, and it's the one I've been using on all my devices for over a year now. The next two tools are related to my email communication. I still have a Gmail address, and I don't see that changing anytime soon, but I also have a secure email inbox that only gets used with my accountant, my lawyer, and other people that deal with my most sensitive information. For this, I use ProtonMail, although there are other options that I've tested that you can see here in this video. Now, in addition to secure email, I'm also a huge fan of email aliases. We're asked to give over our email address multiple times a day, and in my experience, most of the time it's just for a simple login or marketing purposes. In those cases, I've created specific aliases that I give out for shopping sites, newsletters, logins, and even coupons. Most secure email providers allow you to create these aliases, but I've also used Simple Login to do it, and that works really well. Both of these work just fine. Speaking of communication, I use multiple messaging apps out of necessity. I think we all do that based on where we connect with different people. In some cases, it really doesn't matter. If I start a conversation with somebody on Twitter DM, I'm not necessarily going to try to move that thread over to another platform. Now, I feel pretty comfortable with the encryption of iMessage, to be honest. But in the cases where not everybody is using an Apple device, or we simply want private communication outside of the Apple or Android ecosystem, I use and recommend Signal. Now, there are other great private messaging options like Threema and Session, but enough people already have a Signal account that I find that the easiest to use, the least barrier to entry. The next three tools are all virtual services that I use to mask my personal data. It's kind of like email aliases, but in this case, I'm trying to hide my personal address, my mobile number, and my credit card number with a virtual address, a secondary phone number, and a virtual credit card. While privacy is certainly a driving concern here, I'll be honest and tell you that control and access are equally important. I hate dealing with physical mail, so having a virtual address where my mail is received and handled digitally is such a relief for me. With credit cards, I hate having to deal with fraudulent charges and the hassle of getting a new credit card. I would much rather have merchant-specific cards on which I can place a time and/or money limit. I've talked about that in another video. And of course, a secondary number that isn't tied to my SIM card is super helpful as somebody who lives overseas and needs to get certain text messages no matter where I am. Also, I just don't like giving out my personal cell phone number. Personally, I use Postscan Mail for my virtual address, privacy.com for my credit cards, and Hushed for virtual phone number. Finally, there are two services that I don't necessarily think about on a daily basis, but they're working in the background every day, and they've become really valuable to me. The first is a service that continually scans the internet to find where my personal data is being sold and then make legal removal requests. That's Delete Me that you've heard me talk about before. It's effective, and most people just don't realize how much information is floating around that can easily be erased. The second is a credit monitoring service. Now, for most people, I think that setting up a credit freeze is more than enough to keep you safe. But for those of us like me who have already been the victim of identity fraud, there is value in having external monitoring of your credit. Oh, and I also monitor my kids' credit. You'd be shocked at how often this gets stolen and how damaging it can be for young adults. Those are the 12 privacy and security tools that I use on a daily basis. Again, none of these companies paid to be part of this list, but I will have affiliate links in the description if you'd like to support what I'm doing here. Also, feel free to leave a comment if you think that I've missed anything.